In this illustration, we'll study about a rotating rod with an electric dipole. It is saying that a uniform rod of length L and mass M is pivoted at the center O. This is the center O where the rod is pivoted, as shown. At the top end of the rod, a dipole of dipole moment P is fixed along the length of rod. And it is saying if a uniform electric field E is switched on in region toward right, we are required to find angular speed of rod when it becomes horizontal. So, if we apply an electric field E vector toward right, this will exert a torque on this dipole, and as we have studied, the torque on a dipole will be a couple and it does not depend on the axis of rotation. So, P cross E will be the torque and it will rotate the rod in clockwise sense. So, here we can write, if the rod will rotate, then in final state, we can conserve energy with respect to the initial state and find out the kinetic energy of this rod. So, if we calculate the initial interaction energy of dipole with electric field, this can be given as minus P dot E. And here you can see the angle between dipole moment and electric field is 90 degrees, so this will be zero. And further, if we calculate the final interaction energy of dipole with electric field, so this U final can be calculated when the rod becomes horizontal after rotating by 90 degrees. So, in the final state here, as space is less, I'm just symbolically drawing the picture. So, after rotating by 90 degrees, the angle between P and E is 0 degrees. So, we can write it as minus P dot E is equals to minus PE. And here we can write work done by electric forces on rod is, here, this is the work done by electric forces, so this we write as initial energy minus final energy, which is 0 minus of minus PE, that is equals to PE. And this is the work done which is supplying kinetic energy to the rod. So, if omega is the angular speed attained by rod, we use PE is equals to half I omega squared, that is the kinetic energy gain by this work done. So, here moment of inertia of the rod about its central axis of rotation I can write as ML square by 12 multiplied by omega square. So, on simplifying this, I am getting the value of omega as root of 24 PE divided by ML squared. That will be the answer to this problem.